Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? At a visual magnitude of zero, Vega is the fifth brightest star in the entire night sky, seen easily, even from city locations. Though this star seems to steal much of the brightness thunder from the other stars in the diminutive constellation of Lyra the Harp, the other stars in the area seem to make up for it, with fantastic color and double star configurations. And many are not far from Vega itself. The star Sheliac in Lyra, here, is of intense interest too, because despite appearing somewhat dim to our eyes at around 3.5 magnitude, it is actually a double star system that shines as brightly as 2,000 of our suns. And though these two stars orbit far too closely to separate visually, they do eclipse each other from our line of sight every 6.5 days, dipping from 30 to 50% in brightness as one star shines more brightly than the other, causing changes in magnitude with the pattern of eclipses. But Lyra is full of interesting doubles. With binoculars or a finder scope, start at Vega and move all of a degree and a half in the direction of Deneb and Cygnus. This short hop leads to the star Epsilon Lyrae, which can be seen in lower power optics as a double star. But these two stars each hold a secret. This is where a larger aperture telescope, good optics, and a steady sky are required, because not one, but both of those stars are each a double star themselves, though very close together. This is the famous double-double star, and it really is that easy to find, but splitting both stars takes those better optics and good skies. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. Fully shielded lights that use motion sensors to turn on only when necessary, and that turn off when unneeded, are the most efficient way to light up a given area and maintain safety. Now from Vega, head towards Altair, past 4.3 magnitude Zeta, onto Delta Lyrae. Actually, Delta 1 and Delta 2. Delta 1 is the dimmer visually at 5.5 magnitude, but a hotter blue spectral class B star, visible first on your way into this area. Just over 10 arc minutes away is Delta 2, a 4.2 magnitude M-class red giant star that is much cooler, but closer to us, which causes it to appear brighter. In addition to the striking visual contrast, there is a significant temperature difference. Blue Delta 1 is 18,000 Kelvin, while red Delta 2 is 5 times cooler at a mere 3,600 Kelvin. The magnitude difference also makes sense, given that Delta 1 is 200 light-years further from Earth at 1,100 light-years distance, while Delta 1 is 900 light-years away. The color difference between them is like comparing a propane torch and the glowing coals of a fire. But there's more. But it will require a telescope of moderate to large aperture. Right where these two stars are in the sky is an open cluster, alternately called Stevenson 1 or Delta Lyrae 1. With a 4.5-inch scope, I could see about 10 stars in the immediate area. Not all are members of the cluster, which is rather loose and not well-defined, but there are a dozen or so, and likely more, that were born out of the same gas cloud around 60 million years ago, and are about the same age as Delta 1 Lyrae. Keep in mind that Delta 2 is merely a foreground object here, and some other stars in the area are as well. Venus doesn't gain much in altitude or brightness this week, but does scoot away from Gemini towards Cancer over the course of 7 days. Meanwhile, Saturn is less than a half a degree from 4.2 magnitude star Kappa Virginis in the southwestern evening sky. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.